I am by no means a political demagogue. I don't vote for politicians. I have never even been to a political conference. This is a documentary film for humanity and for justice. Period.
I'm getting like $300 for my month, and that really cannot do anything. So I'm pleading, begging, asking if I can get assistance on the behalf of myself and my children.
I show them the situation, I show them evacuation letter, then they send me and do the same thing and bring the letter and they photocopy it for them. After that, I haven't got anything from none of them.
And the next hurricane season is coming. Can I say that kind of, condition?
I already get so much good offers already. Nothing happened on to the book yet.
Not yet, okay.
To leave, which one to do believe? I not give up. I'm not living my life. I know, well, anytime now, as of me now, you're over now, you and beyond. I'll almost come in so way, so high, baby. Because, hey, my means then of situation is not good at all, okay? I am in need, bad. I'm almost in need.
No water, no toilet, no bathroom, the roof leaking, when rain fall in my bed, my pillow, everywhere waiting under the house, flooding the water, the kitchen 700%.
He doesn't ever come here, he never come there, neither Reginald. Reginald come right there and talk to the lady there, show him where I live in. Up to now, nothing. All they're telling me, they will check me, they will check me, they will check me.
Nothing yet.
That and not give me notice. So he tell me he will give me a letter. I tell him, okay, tell me, come back the Thursday. I say, and I really tell him, yes. When I went, no letter. Secretary don't know nothing about that. And she was supposed to make it. Anyways, I got a little heartbroken. I cried because I check in. I really need that okay, and he promised me.
I'm going through struggle for a very long number of years. I never had a sweet life. And I have a suit of God.
That big one is my own.
Hmm?
That big one there.
There are people that can afford it, that getting houses, they're buying houses, and they can build their own. And we that at the back, we cannot get us yet. Our name not there. I guess we are too poor. We cannot get a house.
Myself.
In the early 90s, Superwood Products Limited was contracted to construct 40 residential homes in the Portsmouth Chance Housing Scheme. Only 7 were built, 2 3-bedrooms and 5 2-bedroom dwellings, all incomplete. By 2004, 2 of the 7 buildings were dilapidated to the ground. In 2010, the 5 remaining homes were bought from the government of Dominica by able men and women, both in and out of Portsmouth. In 2009, ALBA, the Venezuelan government, commenced a new housing project to build 10 3-bedroom homes. The purpose of this project, however, is to alleviate the plight of single parents and unable individuals in Portsmouth living under very harsh conditions. In 2013, diabolically and unjustly enough, due to political alliances and preferences, the worst of the worst got swept under the rug like dirt, whilst other undeserving individuals received these 10 homes. This is their story, the neglected ones.
What? For what?
Come look. Is it enough? Okay. My name is Kathy Jonope. I'm 35 years old. I live in Zikak. I have 5 children. The ages are 14, 16, 10, and 2. Let me wash our dishes. This is where we bathe. And this is the inside of my house. One room house, my stove inside. I pay in $50 every month, and I'm not so pleased about the condition we are living in. We're going in the bedroom right now.
I'm putting for the rest of
my father. This is my room. Oh, yeah, one bed.
So 2 adults live inside there, and how much children? 5 children?
5 children.
So who sleeps where?
Well, Shannon and Cheval are the twins. They sleep on the bed. Daniel sleeps on the sofa. Martin sleeps in the hall.
Mm-hmm.
And yes. And me and Shisha sleep on the floor.
Okay.
Yesterday, I went and collected by my sister.
Okay, go ahead. Tell me what Joshua did for you.
He wrote a letter to Honorable Skerritt, Ian Douglas, for assistance to help me with a house, but since that he died.
Mm-hmm.
I still have the letter in my hand, so I don't know if I will get assistance with it on behalf of my children especially.
Okay.
Yeah, sure. What do you want?
I leave the address for you, man.
Thank you.
Rippies.
I am not so happy about the living condition that I'm living in. Also, I'm working and I'm getting like $300 for my months, and that really cannot do anything. And it's very difficult because I have like 3 of them going to high school PSS, and most of the time when they get up in the morning, they'll be going to school without breakfast. sometimes no lunch, sometimes no supper. And it's very hard and thing. So
what about for like for the new school year and thing, how difficult it does be?
Well, for the school year it has been very difficult. Well, I get an assistance from my friend Junon, and I am very, very thankful that he's helping on the behalf of those children. I know for sure Yvonne, my friend in Lagos, got a letter from since 2007, somewhere there, and other people. And
are these people in worse conditions than you right now?
Well, when I really check it, no.
Yes.
Don't you find it is kind of unjust that people get in land and house and you are in worse condition than them and they bypass you straight?
It's true, very true. I don't think it's fair because we've all of us voting and thing, and when I really check it, it's like one set alone that get in and they doesn't see the other side and thing. And like Mali need the assistance just like me. Because Mali, when I really watch it, Mali in a situation where anytime the house might just fall on him and thing. And with me, I'm just renting and there's no light, no water, no toilet, no bathroom, nothing and thing. So I think we need assistance. Even this set of people really, really need the assistance. And things. So
comparing to people that you hear in that got property.
Yes. My only son, he's 16 years. He's not staying with me. I guess his frustration, that is why you see he do things that he's not supposed to do.
Such as
marijuana, always in fight, always in police station. And I cannot really blame him because of the condition that we're living in. And right now he's not even staying with me, he's by a friend staying with. So I guess it's all that have frustration, have him frustrated and think so. So I'm asking, pleading, begging again for assistance. Kids, baby, mute.
And you're off to see the Prime Minister.
Oh yes, baby.
Well, best of luck. I hope everything works for you.
Thank you. EPM went to school. She went to me the letter, please. Why? What part up?
My name is Jane Jonas, better known as Bernadette. I live in Chance since 1991 with my husband and 8 children. 7 children.
Yeah.
And myself make 8. And I've been through struggle from since 2005 after my husband died. Some people come and claim, they come and claim the lot, they come and claim my house. And up till present now, I've been going up and down, and I doesn't get no reply. Well, they say they put my name on the lot.
Which lot?
This one.
Okay.
They have my name on it. But up to now, I cannot get my letter. Now, many people are going to court for my house. Now, they are claiming the small little one, which me and my husband built, they are still claiming it as their own also.
Mm-hmm.
So in other words, now they want to put me out, they want to put out my children from that place, and I cannot allow that to happen.
Okay.
You know, I work too hard. I see too much misery. So, you know, I make a report in the station and told them 4 days from now since my husband was missing.
Yeah.
So then they was on a search for him. And then his friends now was on a search also. So when they found him dying in the bush
mm-hmm.
on the 15th of January, they found him. And then they brought him. So anyway, they bring him down. So in the meantime now, two police officers came together with me here at my home. And his family and my family. So in the meantime, while we're here, we've seen a man which I didn't know about, which my husband said didn't know him. I didn't know him. But his girlfriend was my friend, so I knew her. Come here and told me that my husband, come here and say, I'm your husband. Your husband sold the land and the house. He was not repeating about the small one, only the big one.
The big house, yeah.
Only the big one he was talking about.
So that house is yours then?
Yes.
Papa freaking
bodgy. That's what I told you.
Okay.
So they come and say, my husband sold a big house for them, so we got for my toilet and the house. And presently, right now, they're trying to throw me from my little house, saying they bought the little house too, and saying that I come and beg a thing. You find it making sense? I come and beg to give you my
own place. In your own property?
In my own property. How can I, why can I be so crazy and so stupid to do that? You know? So that is the verdict they're using. Stating that, well, this girl, since they asked me, because they didn't know what is going on yet, so they said they was going to build me a house.
And that's housing?
That is housing.
Yeah.
So he answered me that this letter.
Let me see.
The same letter, I'll just show you there. And they haven't made any house for me. Now he had asked me to turn that house there.
Mm-hmm.
That is a small one. They asked me to turn so that they could have built the house for me. Now I need that house there to fix, because since I turned it, the house not 100% again.
Right, it got worse.
You know, it gets worse. It's leaking. And it's not on properly pillars.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I had full of foam in the house, in the housing office. So
to get one of the petrol casters. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, to get some material, you know, to
okay.
fix it. Since in 2010 I do that. But I haven't got no reply. I don't know what is going on.
Yeah.
People that really in need, them that do not get in. So I find sometimes it's very unfair. It's very, very unfair, because people that really need doesn't get a house nor a land. And people that can able them to help themselves, they're the one who get it. It's in people coming out from all over. People come out of all country and they come in right inside of Chance. And people that in Chance, most of us cannot get nothing.
Yeah, that have been on this struggle for quite a while.
Quite a while been going on. That is ridiculous. That is not fair. That is not fair to the people. And they have to try to do something. They have to try to put justice where justice is going. You know, they have to put justice. Look for something. Don't look in one way and not look in the other way. Look for those that really in need it. You know? I mean, all of us need it, but it are those that need more.
More, yeah.
Yes. Those that need more. So you know what I really suspect?
Right.
Most thing that is happening in the place, the Prime Minister doesn't know anything. He doesn't know unless somebody do come before him to show him what is going on. He doesn't know. You know, sometimes people blame the government, but most of the time he doesn't know what is going on. It's true. He doesn't know really what is going on most of the time. You know? Especially according to the people he put. According to the people that they put to watch things around. You know, they do what they want. They choose who they want. You like, if you're not their people, they put you off on a side. And those that work together with them, those that come together with them, that is who they're checking.
Sure.
The government doesn't know nothing most of the time. Yeah?
Go for that room. You wanna in there? Huh?
My own one room.
Okay. Great things he has done, eh?
Yes, sir. You can get on top here.
Mm-hmm. And they're still leaking?
Yeah, what is really funny? Leaking in my room, it's leaking in the hall. Sorry. When everybody was sleeping on the floor?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, it was just like just that little piece alone.
So
all
that
of us was in that little piece alone.
So the little area that where everybody was?
Everybody. In that from here today, and it's after we extend on that little piece.
Okay.
Yes.
So basically on that floor in there, there where everybody was taking their sleep,
yeah,
eh?
Yeah, and that little floor. Our kitchen, so it was our kitchen, our room, our hall, everything.
Okay.
So we just used to take a curtain and, you know, by way as a bedroom. I know some of these ceiling go down, they hold certain pillars properly. So.
And that's how you live in?
That's how I live in. I believe in God, so I know one day things will go right.
Yeah.
And my children to send to school, right now the last one in high school.
Yeah.
So it's really tough, yes? It's really tough. I never had a happy life in it. Never. I know I am happy with God,
mm-hmm.
but not on earth, not physical with men. I don't happy with them.
Why would you say that? You never had a happy life?
No, what I mean, I have a happy life going through struggles.
How old are you now?
I'm 52.
Okay.
I'm going through struggle for a very long number of years. I never had a sweet life. I know I have it with God, but not with men.
Nothing that is.
Huh?
Nothing that is.
Nothing that is, then. And believe me, I'd rather to see all my misery on earth. I'd rather to see the misery on earth. I know it's not sweet, but I'd rather to see it than for my soul to go there. I'd rather get all the joy in the heaven. Mm-hmm. To get the joy in heaven.
My name is Christine Popon. I'm 29 years old. I live with my 5 children. Their name are Selena Langley, which is 12 years old, Jerry Langley, which is 10 years old, Amelia Popon, which is 8 years old, Trishel Langley, which is 7 years old, and Kristen Popon, which is 1 year old.
This is my living room. Where we sit down, watch TV, play games. That's my bedroom. That's where me and my little baby sleeps. That's the wardrobe. It's kind of bowling between the room and the partition because it was just one room I was there, and because of the situation that to split to make a partition, a hall and a room. Through the room, someone to the kitchen. and through the kitchen you're supposed to go to the it's one room but a toilet and a children room.
What is that?
I haven't got more space because of the situation. So that is the computer taking on a cold because of so narrow. I cannot put everything with that.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the room for the kids. It's small.
So that is the student room?
Yeah, that's the student room for now. That's what I have. And right in the room, they have the toilet. Right there.
Okay. And there's your bathroom and toilet.
My living condition is, I have a little, like, just quite like a little ghetto for me and my five children, which it haven't got enough space because I have a couch there, a little narrow alley. Two person can even pass to walk if in case of an emergency. I have the little room, which I have to, everybody have to come in my kitchen to get something. I have to more space in my bedroom to come in my kitchen, which I do not agree of. My kids living in a, like, their room is a toilet and a bedroom because of the little small tiny area which I can have my kids sleeping together with me in the same bed. And okay, I went to, like, after all the incident, I went to, like, Ian Douglas and I told him about my situation and thing. He sent me by Rudolph Thomas and get a carpenter to do an invoice for me of materials. Then after he sent me, I went by Rudolph, I get everything. I brought in the invoice for him. And I keep on going back behind him. Every Thursday when he in office, I go in. He give me a different story. He tell me they don't get materials, they don't get thing. Then after the last time he talked to me, he told me like he trying to get the petrocarib for me. But the petrocarib have everybody already for them. So I keep on going there again, nothing. Then after I went to housing division up in Zikak, Chance. I showed them the situation, I showed them evacuation letter. Then they send me and do the same thing and bring the letter and they photocopy it for them. After that, I haven't got here anything from none of them. I was staying at Zikak, me and my kids, which we couldn't able to pay for our rent. And they put me out. It didn't have light, it didn't have toilet, not nothing, no water, not nothing. And my children father had got an incident with his hand, which like it just bring us back down to zero because he wasn't working and myself was working. I was getting a little funds from welfare, but they had stopped it not too long there. They stopped it. So I went across by the housing scheme and occupy a house for me and my kids and
it was empty
house. Yes, it wasn't, it didn't have windows, it didn't have door. But in the distress, we take galvanize and we make door windows and we take thing and we bow and make door. We had a week there. We clean up the area, weed up everything. We had a week. While we there, I just came out river washing because higher up have a river. Just came out river washing. Mapping came, Reginald Ostry came, and Mammy's came. And they tell us we couldn't, they flim us, they tell us we couldn't stay there.
because of the house was under mommy's supervision because of the maybe contract they had and it was not finished. So they had to make us like evacuate the area. So I didn't have no choice and take my kids and just evacuate and end up in that situation where I be right now. My children father had a deal with a guy that he wanted him to do some dumper box for him, but he didn't have the money to pay. So he agreed, you know, he had a two-bedroom thing that he had a store in. So he agreed, you know, we'll do the job for him and we end up getting the house so we can check our little scene, put it on the piece of land and stay in. But I don't know what go wrong when we do thing the deal, like some he telling us like his girlfriend end up selling it for somebody else. So like that leave us back again just how we be there right now, stranded. Well, where you see there's just a piece of the house, that's where I put an extension because of my 5 kids. But the house is much bigger than that. My uncle came out from America claiming there was his own, which I understood in times of talking. That's a family house. That's my mother and father house, which all her children had seen. I raised up there with my mother, but as she died, we end up staying in there because we don't have nowhere to go. My uncle came claiming that his own and we have to move out. But we still didn't study him. It's on the 14th of August, 2013, when we received the lawyer, 2012, is when we received the lawyer paper stating that we have to evacuate from the building and police was involved. Police came there the early morning and things like that. So when the police talked to us, we told him, like, on the other side was his own, but where I be right now, where the kitchen be and the bedroom, is like an extension I put on it while all of us was there with my 5 children. So they insist me of, like, going and, like, pull up in my place until I get something organized.
We start making a whole set of noise with him, cussing him up, ready to fight with him, telling him he just caught America without nothing, with his 2 hands swinging and he want to come and claim there for his and things like that. Then the police tell us that doesn't matter and he talk to us and calm us down.
So what did your uncle say after that now?
Well, we stay enemy with him for a couple of days, but his family, we still end up talking back to him and he talking to us.
So did he ever like agree that, checking them, okay, well, he can send the house still?
No, he's still claiming he wants his house for him to repair and move out from there and bring to Lago on land, on his property.
So if he want to move here and bring on his property, what about the land here? What happened to
the land? Well, the land here was my uncle's land, which was called Free Casey land. But end up now, I don't know what deal or what something, what he end up selling it for my auntie, that's his sister's son in America. So the land is still not my uncle now. Land is my cousin land now. Yes.
Okay, but the house is your uncle?
Well, the house he claims is his house. So this is house.
Alright.
A guy they call Joshua Watts, like, he see my situation and he told me he'll help me through the government. He make me do the estimation again of the house. He took the lawyer paper and he took the lawyer paper, then he went and he made some letters. He sent one to Reginald Austrey, one to the Prime Minister, Mr. Scary. They sent one to Reginald Austrey, one to Welfare and one to Housing. Welfare came and interviewed me, but after that I haven't heard from any one of them. So I don't know what's happening, what's going on, what's cooking up. It's stressful. The options I had is just to take out my things in his part and just try to squeeze myself in that little thing there with me and my children. That's the only options I have. I start trying off on my own, like to see if I could do my make my little house and things like that, but the income for me is not there. I have to just depend on the children father to give me, and sometimes when he give me, I cannot do anything much with it because I have school fees to pay. Still, I have light to pay, I have water to pay, and still a strength to eat. I can't leave my children hungry, and I have to maintain them. So, like, it'll be stressful, but I just try to push and see what I can do for them. The only way I can stay right now is to rent, and I don't have the money for that. I don't have the money for renting right now. Well, I got a piece of land in Chance from the government, which I not 100% finished paid for it, but I'm paying for it. I was trying, like, to, like... I went to the government to assist me with some materials to try to make a, at least even though it's a two bedroom, even though they don't give me windows, they don't give me doors, nothing. But just to help me make a little shanky, something for me and my children can stay in and try to live comfortable than inside of that. If the Prime Minister watching, I know he's not a bad Prime Minister, but I'm just asking for help. Please. I'm just trying to ask to, for you to help me so I can come out in that little hole there.
Okay, my name is Brenda John from Portsmouth, Lagos. But right now I reside at Chance. I have a two-bedroom house. Five of us stays here. With bathroom, toilets, and stuff. And I am married right about now. And I, long before I met my husband, I applied for a house in Chance. I registered my name, and then after that I get married, but I keep on coming back over and over to Mr. Joseph for the house to find out what is it, what's going on. Mr. Joseph, well, I call him Mr. Joseph, I don't know his other name, but I call him Mr. Joseph. He's the one, I guess, that is in charge of the housing thing over there. So I keep on going to him more than 10 times. He sent me to Rosa to check to housing in Rosa about it. They told me that if anything, if my name will come up, it's impossible. They have to send it down here and then they will distribute the letters to whoever name that come up for the houses. But anyway, I keep on coming back over and over again. He sent me to Morica to find out what is what's going on. She told me that all the Morica is I think is regional secretary.
Regional Austria.
Yes, regional Austria secretary. She told me that all the houses have been given to whoever the houses belong to, that they get their papers already for the house. So that she told me no more house for anybody again. I go back, I tell it to him. From that, my situation in Lagos, which I was renting a house in Lagos, but then due to my situation, I cannot maintain it how it was to things. So anyway, I leave, and a friend put me in their place, which the lady had to build on her side of a house to put me in, which I rent in, but it's cheaper than where I was at first.
Okay.
So I had to leave Lagos to come up here. When I reach up here, a friend gave my husband a piece of, well, what he squatted. He told my husband that he could have it. My husband go, he starts cleaning the land. From there, Mr. Joseph tells us that the house is not government house. The house is Silmer, the land is Silmer Deputy land. So we stopped. But yesterday, that was the 15th, I met some women, they arguing on the road about that same land the man told my husband he could have. I went back to Mr. Joseph and asked him, what is the matter with that same land? He told me the lady come to him about that same land, and the same response he gave it to the lady. But the lady go and she started cleaning there. But the owner that gave us the land, the piece of lot, said that he's on the land for 10 to 15 years he'd been on that land. And nobody haven't come on the land since he cleaned that piece of land. He cut down his trees and do whatever. Nobody never come on it. But right now, the lady on it trying to clean it and things. So I don't know what's going on, because if he tell me it is not his own and it is Silma Jupini, and I applied for a house long before most people that get it, I understand that get papers for the houses. By right, I supposed to get a house too. Because it's our people that do not have houses, that they have houses, but they not in all that they can afford it to get. Because remember, they have their children. They have children going to school. They have their bills to pay, which is sometimes they can't even afford to pay the bills. Sometimes the children don't even go to school. They stay home because why? Most times they don't have the financial, you understand? They're supposed to get houses. My situation, I've been in an accident. I go matnik back and forth. My family had to collect money for me to go to matnik. And right now, I still have to go back to matnik. I don't know where the money is going to come out, but I have to find a way. Because of my situation, I have to go back to matnik. I can't have...
What problem you have?
Okay, first they tell me I had brain tumor. And then when I reached matnik, I was supposed to make an operation. which I have been taking medication, but I stopped the medication because I am a Christian. No matter what people say, I am a Christian, and I believe in God, and I know that He can help my situation. You understand? My eyes sick, my head sick, and then it's like hospital, operas, so back and forth, I have to be going. You understand? But due to that situation there, I deserve to have a house because of my four children I have and my family. We cannot afford a home.
You applied much earlier than a lot of people.
Yes, a lot of people I applied. And people I that so far I understood that did not apply, they get in houses. Like I understood, I don't know how true it is. And it is wrong. My mother supposed to get a 3-bedroom house. Up to now they cannot build for her. It have this wo-yo-yo down the road. Up to now they cannot build for them. They need houses too. It's not to be that people that can afford it, that getting houses, they buying houses and they can build their own. And we that at the back, we cannot get us yet. Our name not there. I guess we are too poor. We cannot get a house. It is not right. We bring in our own people and we don't even realize we bring in our own people. People that get these houses, people that dealing with people that they close together, you understand?
In authority.
Right. People that always there with them, drinking bodies or whatever bodies you call them, that get in houses. And it is not right. In my opinion, it is not right. So, the Prime Minister need to come down and find out what is the matter, what going on in Chance with those houses. Find out if it's true that those houses belongs to people. Ask Ian Douglas a question about his houses because I've been to Ian building how many times and he's never there. I always seen his secretary, but I never once talked to Ian in that office on a Thursday. You understand? I don't know what day it is. Not on a Thursday, I make sure I go in there.
Yeah.
But I always go in there and not once I meet Ian in his office. You understand? The Prime Minister need to come down and find out what's happening. Because we need help down here. It's not only people that can afford it that need help. He need to find out because, yes, we vote in Ian. But Ian doesn't do nothing for us. People that have he doing for. We need it. So the Prime Minister need to find out what is good and find out who is the person that don't get us. People that in need of the jobs, he need to go to them and find out what is the situation with them. So I will advise that the Prime Minister that we love, go out there and find out what is it.
Because like you said, did anybody come and make an assessment?
Nobody never come and talk to me about nothing. I've been going to that office up there since I put down my name for that house there. Nobody never asked me a question. I never get a phone call about saying this and that.
Nobody come and visit your house.
Nobody never come and visit nothing.
Wow, this is frightening. Very frightening because I cannot understand that you are selecting people for houses and yet still no assessment is being made to see what the person's condition is, to see if they are worthy of getting those houses.
House. That is not right. They say put down names for houses, those that in need. All you have the papers, all you see those that in need of it. Go and find out what is the situation with that person. Go and talk to that person to find out what is the situation. If it's truly they need that house, go and see if really and truly they cannot afford the house. It is not right what's going on up there. It is totally not right. Well, all I can say, those that do have a house, just keep praying that God will answer our prayer. They will. It's politics that's going on right now. So we just have to keep our faith. Well, I know I have faith. So I will still believe that God will make a way for me. And I know I will get a house one way or the other. He will make a way for me and my family.
Since 2001, I have been struggling with Mr. Douglas for a house, and he has been nasty seeing with me, and nobody has been doing nothing for me. I have been going behind Reginald Street, and he has not telling me nothing. So I am, right now I am here, as the owner is here, I am here to call on Mr. Austin to, it's not want, I want a house. It's need, I need of a house. I can't remember the date they give me the letter, but I can remember.
What letter?
Huh?
What letter?
A housing letter for to remove the house. Mm-hmm. I can't remember because probably I lose the letter, so I can't really recall. Mm-hmm. But anyway, me and Bernadette moved our house the same Sunday. And last year, October gave me and Bernadette 10 years since we shipped our house. And up to now, I have not seen Mr. Douglas. Every time I go to him, he running me away from him. So I'm calling on the Prime Minister and on the Minister of Housing to watch that plight and make it, because we are going to next hurricane season. So I'm calling on them with greater plea. And I'm disappointed in the leadership of my father. And I'm calling on the Prime Minister to ask him to step down from active politics. My living conditions are deplorable. And it's very deplorable because I have not a toilet, a bathroom, and the living conditions are very bad. Each of us are living inside here. Two-bedroom house without bathroom, need a toilet, and I am living in a deplorable state. The house is on a downturn. The house is falling flat, and nobody is asking me what I'm selling. Neither my father, neither the Minister of Housing.
So that's your living room area. Go inside now.
Yeah. The house falling so, bad. It's on a ridge. Right?
Mm.
And, well, it's a two-room house. It's like I sleep in here with my wife, and the little girl is sleeping on top, and can be sleeping on top. And the little girl of mine that go in secondary school, she's sleeping below here. So it's in a terrible state. And I'm calling on the authorities to address that problem before the election season. Because I will go on the political platform.
You love your Prime Minister?
Huh?
You love your Prime Minister?
Yeah, I love him, but still those men that working together with him, they're not doing the work that the people put them there to do. If I go and I vote for Ian this year, for the past years I have been voting, and now I have I have voted all my life for the Labour Party. Now for me to get a better living condition, because the money I am making is not sufficient to run my home and keep my family alive.
Mm-hmm.
You know? When I get in $296 and change, that is not money. So I cannot build a house on that. Even though I will save money from that, but as I save, I have to go and take out my children want to shoes, I have to go and take out money to buy shoes for them. It don't make sense. So that is the next living area.
So who's sleeping there?
Kenyan.
You have light inside there?
Yeah.
Put on the light, please.
Huh?
Put on the light for the room. Okay. So who's sleeping inside there, you say?
Kenyan, what is her name? Kenyan.
Hold on.
Me and my wife sleeping here.
Why is that?
Me and my wife sleeping here. And Jivan and Shinika sleeping on top there. Okay?
So yeah. Four of all you sleeping inside there?
Huh?
Four of all you sleeping inside there?
Yeah. She's sleeping on top there, the smaller little girl sleeping on top here, and then Jivan and Shinika.
So where your wife sleep?
Huh?
Where does your wife sleep?
Below here.
Okay.
Below here. Three of us are sleeping there.
So three of all you sleep on this tiny little bottom bunk?
Yeah.
Okay. So three of all you sleep on that little bottom bunk?
Yeah, three of us.
Okay. And who sleeps on top?
Yeah, Shane, you can sleep on top. When Clarissa here is on top here, she sleeps.
Okay, so normally normally six people sleep in that little room?
Yeah, six people sleep in that little room. Okay. But as Clarissa not here, the last little girl of mine is sleeping on top here all the time. Well, the kitchen is a kitchen that not guaranteed. It is not good. It is leaking, and we have quite little space inside here. It's called the whole living condition is deplorable. Me and Douglas have been giving me cock and bull story every time I go to him. Those houses in Chance have names on it. So at that time, I get so vexed until I tell him, but you couldn't leave out a person that cleaning the gutters of Portsmouth and giving houses to young people that don't even contribute their life to the town. Their life to the town for a little bit of money. All of us have contributed our life to the town for no money at all, even my wife and all. So he have keep on frustrating me, and all down the line, I have been frustrated, and seeing that we are going into the next election year, I feel I should go on the political platform and ask. And as you are here, to ask Mr. the Prime Minister of the state to ask Mr. Douglas to step down from active politics, because we have no use in Portsmouth and his office is null and void. Legal affairs and tourism is null and void because he has no respect for the lower class. We have no respect for the lower class of people that work in the jail. No manners, no respect for the lower class of people that are working in the jail. Without us working in the jail, without us cleaning the town has no value. And I believe the ministers of government in this era. The ministers of government in this era are supposed to have a right to respect the son and the and sincerity of the people that clean the gutters, that taking the scent, that taking the smell, and no money behind it. When you getting $26, $27 for your deed, can you run a home with those kind of money that you getting?
Can you build a house with that money?
Can you build a house and run your family? Not even college you can send your children on that political money. So I am asking the government to look into raising daily paid workers, giving them a little more incentive to work. And I'm calling on the Prime Minister to ask Mr. Douglas. The constituency don't want Mr. Douglas anymore because he has no use for the development of the poor and the dumb children. My mother was giving me problem for that land. And I have been going to Mr. Douglas off and on, and he has been frustrating my mind. So I had to forget about it. And last year, September, the 20th of September, the Prime Minister had a meeting in Ganvilia. I had to go to him. And I had embarrassed Ian. So since from the embarrassment of Ian, Ian don't want to do nothing for me. Because he find I was too small with his might to go to the Prime Minister and embarrass him in front of the Prime Minister. And he has been looking, also I know of a young girl that he look for a piece of land for and they're going to build for her. That is Masha.
Mm-hmm.
That is a girl for Cleo. And I'm seeing that seeing that she's going to clean the land and build. Every day I've been in chance asking the partner what happened, and the partner inside in chance giving me cock and bull story. So I'm calling on Mr. Oshu as Minister of Housing to take a serious stand to give me a house. If not one time, I want a house I need. If he was in my place and he had need of a house, if I was a government minister and he had need of a house, I'd give him.
In the condition that you're in right now?
Right, in the condition I am in there now, I need to get a house and nobody asking me what I'm selling. And when it's election, they come in, Mali, you vote already, I go and vote. I cannot go and put my ex, my finger in red ink and vote for Mr. Douglas no more.
Mm-hmm.
Because he has no use to the public. So when I started to see that, I went up to Vickers this Saturday, but I didn't meet the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister had gone out to funeral. Then I tried to meet with him again. I couldn't get in charge with him. So Sunday, this Sunday, I got and put a $20 gas in a friend of mine car, and we're going to go to Mr. Oshu. And something has to happen, because I cannot stay in that kind of condition. It is deplorable. It is just not in condition. Because when men come there to my wife and my children being there, that is unsanitary. Not even me that can be there.
Mm.
I have to run in the bathroom. So they need to, and I'm calling on them to speedily execute that housing problem for me.
What is that?
Huh?
Where the children live in?
Yeah, they live in.
So the children will be right there?
Yeah.
Okay. And your wife does be here sometimes?
Yeah, sometimes my wife. Every time it's my wife living. But as the toilet opens, she will more go in the toilet.
Okay.
I tell her they're not the same for her to be.
Mm-hmm.
And the children don't want to go in the bathroom. They be in here. Again, my father. I'm not supposed to go to Reginald, neither. I'm not supposed to go to Reginald, neither. Now you're scared, you know. You come and promise me and all you can fulfill all you promise. All you have to fulfill all you promise. And the next point I want to make, that they had some houses, the same houses of Julie. I asked Mr. Douglas to fix one. If I had to pay for it, my sister then could help me pay for it. Up to now, they sell those houses on me. And I never get one. Now, the same thing that's going to happen to those houses.
The petrocastles.
Petrocarry houses. But I'm not going to make, I put it down my foot. I am not going to make no young girl get house before me there. And I'm going to miss the house on Sunday. So by Monday's a holiday, by Tuesday, I want to hear his verdict. I want to hear what he doing for me.
Have any of the ministers ever came here to check out your living condition?
No. None of them.
Have you invited them?
I had invited Usher just come right there by Mr. Rose. I invited him. He came. But he had never come. He never come. Usher come once. And he never come back. Security is paying him to do his job and Ian is not performing. You can make sure he can come in. You don't know how strong the hurricane will come. You're not passing 10 years. Come on, 10 years. Not doing the work. You're not doing the work that you're supposed to do. Not satisfying the people. When you see you go and you talk on me like that, people just hate you, but I look like I don't have no books, no light to me myself. So it's true. 10 years? Huh? If all you don't want to give me material, give me one of those houses all you have up there. Put light, put water, and that is it I want. Once I get it, I'm satisfied. My children can live in a good living condition.
My name is Ted Rapport, age 45, living in Portsmouth all my life. I live in three children living with me, Jasmine Joseph, Jovan Peter, and Dylan Carriott. Who feels it knows? Who feels that?
That's your casa.
Mm-hmm. You can even put the bread of those holes be and this bubble gum be on top there. Really not for wet in there, so. All right, you see this bubble gum. The bubble gum there. Put that with the bubble gum there. We to block the hole there. With my pillow, we don't wet in there like that. My pillow, we. Galvanized boy nail boy galvanized and house sweating. Flood I flooding inside and rain falling.
And look, you see, I see you have your other monster hole inside there.
I know there's stone again, hole in the galvanized again. The stone, that hole in it there. So the water to run down by outside.
Okay.
All that are waiting. That is the house, that is the roof. There's lot of carry that. There's lot of house that way. 9 years, no water, no toilet, no bathroom, the roof leaking, when rain fall in my bed, my pillow, everywhere waiting under the house, self flooding with water, the kitchen 700%. Well, the yard now, it's me that made the yard looking how we looking there.
Mm.
Me that I be looking how we looking there today. I asked the owner of the house for water ready, tell me he will try, he will see, up to
for
now.
For how long now you doing that?
For how long now I don't ask any man for water, almost 3 years, right?
Mm.
Now since I asked him for water, this year there, I asked him for water, he tell me put the water, if I'm missing a piece of pipe, he will put it again. Well, if you have to do all that, it's better you forget about it.
Yeah.
And I will continue with my pillow water until God help me, I get somewhere maybe better. The roof self not good at all. If truck passing there, the house shaking. The last time a truck passed there, it passed too close to the fence.
Mm-hmm.
Go with the fence. At the back there, I had to fix it the same day. Because they had exposed, they had open. Yeah, since my child was 1 month, I put him on my shoulder. Baby, I go house and I get the paper. The lady tell me they'll get in contact with me. Up to now, they don't get in contact with me yet. I go, I take another form again, I fold it. I make man no sign, man no sign. No, my child is 11 years. Nobody can come to me and tell me nothing about the land, the form, the paper, who will help me, nothing. When I see it's true, nobody doesn't take me on, nobody doesn't sign form, nobody doesn't tell me nothing. I just forget about that, eh? I leave that alone.
So when you hear there was houses in chance
available? Houses in chance available. When I go, they say they take down my name, they will call me up to now. I tell the man the other day, if you don't see my name there, the man tell me you don't see my name. So I tell the man, well, I had full form. So it looked like they tear the form. They do the, put the form where they put it, and playing like they doesn't see it. So I tell the man, why are you coming there now? I know what people get in land, get in house. Well, it are people that get the house already. So what about me now, that full form? Since my child 1 month, now he 11 years. All that time I can't get a spot, I can't get nowhere. I already go up by the PM in Rosary. The lady tell me, oh, the PM in a meeting. I tell her, okay, take my name down. Look my number and he will call me. Never call. When I rarely get his number, I start texting him. My problem, I live in a 40 rent, one die. I'm a disabled parents. I is a single parents too, where I live in a house full of holes, no water, no toilet. I carry water from the time I come here, and I have 9 years since I here. Mm. I carry water. I pay in Paro to carry my water. There is not a place I can keep no poo in the yard because they're too small. I have to go on my job fast and go on poo. I cannot go on all my life like that poo in plastic or going on my job and poo. Talk to Ian Jamil, talk to Reginald. When Ian make me go by Reginald make me feel bad.
Why did all Reginald make you feel bad?
Reginald tell me, oh, I'm not your PM. I'm not your, what do you call him name?
Not part of the constituency.
Yes, in the area. Go back by Ian. When I go by Ian tell me not he's Reginald. I say, okay. Or you have me like a frigging bumping ball. I forget about that. I leave that alone. When I start hearing them about chance now, I say, okay, people squatting in chance. Let me fool it for me again to see if they won't give me a spotting chance up to now. All about in chance block. They say you don't have no more places. They say they have houses, those names done already for houses. Ian said I cannot afford the house. $14,000 for a house, I cannot afford the house. I tell him, what that make you so sure I cannot afford the house? So what I working for? The same man who I working for cleaning the park. I is the lady that cleaning the park. Why I cannot get a spot in chance? Yeah. Don't never believe I wouldn't pay for my spot. If I get a piece of land today, I wouldn't pay for my land. People that they give houses, I hope they pay for their land. I hope they pay. They don't give me, I don't worry with them. Go chance, I cannot meet the Prime Minister. Text him, he see my name, my surname. 4 o'clock in the morning, a text coming on my phone. He tell me, I get your text, I will call you back. Up to now, the man never call me back. Go chance, I don't get in him. When I go chance last week, they say he go for 2 weeks. I say, okay, when he come back again, that is the last try I try. If I try, I do succeed, I live in that alone. I say I don't want to go to labor again, you know. I say I give up. Eh? He know me like that, man, he know me like that. And I just clean in the park. I see when I clean in the park, we. 7 years right there clean in the park. The 10th of April, give me 7 years I clean in the park, we. All my children and grandchildren coming in the park and help me clean. And I cannot get a sporting chance. I should do like Christine.
And you apply for 11 years, so 11 years ago, and you still applying steady. And
but I doesn't give up. I doesn't give up, but I just check in. I go chance 3 times, me, Kathy and Helen. We don't get any man. The man in chance have all of us number, you know. I even make the man photocopy that. I make him photocopy that. He photocopy it. That letter there. I don't throw it, you know. You see it? I photocopy that for the man. The man take the photocopy. He have it up there, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But Joshua make some letters for me from to give the PM one, Ian one, Reginald one, and I think welfare one.
Mm-hmm.
And he had to just photocopy it for me. Type it out. He make the letters already, but he had to type it out for him, me to bring it rose. So, to give the PM, Ian, Reginald, Mano, and welfare one. But the same week, I hear he died. Same week, I hear he fall long, he died. But I go to his funeral on Sunday. I go to his funeral on Sunday. Me?
Have you ever sit down and discuss with Ian Douglas?
Yes, several times. Several times I tell Ian my problem. But better I didn't tell Ian my problem. Lately I tell Ian we have to talk. Everybody getting houses. You tell me I cannot get house. $14,000 for house. I cannot pay for house. How are you so sure I cannot pay for house? I tell him my child died at 11 years. You never come in my house and talk to me. You was my matters there drinking rum with your friends. You never come here when my child died. Not even hospital. I see them, you know. And we good. Me and them is boss now, we good. I'm not telling Ian my problem again. Ian tell me go by Reginald. Reginald tell me go by, I can understand it. Reginald tell me go back by Ian. Because he's not for Portsmouth. You that for Portsmouth, you're not checking me.
It's not his constituency.
No, it's not his business. That's not his man business. That is Ian to see about his people. He's not seen about his people. I want him to take him out there. I want him to come out there. Because Ian making the country go down. And making people talk too much about the PM. I want him to go down, you know. They have to take him out there. If he don't come out there, I don't vote again, you know. Ian watching my make a pay for house, but maybe those are paying for house and they give us, maybe take them.
To me, that's a direct insult. So when you hear people are getting houses, how does that make you feel knowing that
taking
you are in a worse condition than they are?
But something have to take me. Something taking me. My pressure just rise, me. My pressure rise into something, me. Jasmine spoke to him already, you know, in PSS. About my mother is a single parent, too. Where I go into high school, my mother have to struggle. Why is he mise to send me to school? Why the PM don't look about her mother and give her mother somewhere? Because the little girl there in, people in chance or whosoever, where they come out getting house. Her mother that they labor, no red beans, no cooking on a Sunday. Dry food, dry coke, sweet, and I on labor, dumper. Until when I reach carry breeze away, they did labor pen, more the labor pen, that board, that pala. Nuka sise la, nuka sorti. Today, why can I get somebody to put my children? So long as Judith get a house in Zikage, government give her, she have it closed, and she's still in rent. And she have the government house closed. Not too long, Annette Langley from Maddoxford, working by Ross. Government give her a house too. She, all the time, she have the house closed, she buy her mother. Look, Zai die. The government build house for Zai. The land is Zai own. Why? That is why I tell Ian, why I cannot stay in the house of Zai and let Zai, the government pay Zai children for the land. But the house closed.
I agree to that.
The house closed, you know. And nobody not in Zai house. The person I was taking care of Zai, her two sister, the girl said they tell her they give her the house to stay, you know. She said she not living in the house. Toilet, bathroom, water, everything. We, I need a place where my children gonna see me and my man sleeping together in the night and let them have their own room. I don't want my children to see where I sleep on my bed with my man and they on the other side. So I want to do a cool zip up for the EV and I can add gaba rice good now. I cannot move now in the night and gaba rice good. I want to boil the things sweet and nice, children getting up.
I feel you.
Give somebody that guaying, seeing misery, struggling with their children to give them the house to live. I have a neighbor that has some children there, she doesn't even take care of those children. I even want to take one, but I need somewhere where I can have a toilet, a water, a bathroom, and I can take one. Because on the street they be, they don't have no care. They don't have no love. The children on their own, on the street. I don't joke, you know. I want Ian to come out there. Ian is a bubbler. Ian maybe give who he take house. He can make an offer the house. $14,000 bobo for those house. You cannot afford that. I say, what that make you believe? I cannot afford that. Since you're working, you know where your money sure. And I like a clock, I can spin around fast. What's that by Morris? I just believe in your grandmother. She don't go in peace. She finished. People was wondering how I handle in my hand. But don't worry, they can't put their foot in my shoe. Really get and solve my problem and let my pressure go back normal is to get a place. For me to live in a proper place. And I want the government to see that and I want the government to help me. Me, they calling the bobo there. They're taking care of the park. My phone number, tired, go on his phone. I'm not getting back, no reply. 616-5788, that is my number. That's like a cup of water for anybody. I need to come out here, this year, there. I need to come out there. The next election, I don't want you to take me here. So when I close my house open. I need a proper place for me and my children and my grandchild to live. They don't belong to me. The person getting rich on me, you know. And I go down in the drain. Right. I need a place to live, a proper place. Who are you?
Somebody informed us of a piece of land. It's just a strip of land. It's not really. They said it wasn't for sale because they would not sell it to anybody because it's small, but it's long. So
that's in Chance.
Yes, in Chance. And it had people that built on that same piece of strip. They have about two houses. Now what they did not ask permission. Seeing that trans people, they just went and they squat. So they did the same thing and they built a house. Now, when the person told me to go and do it, I say, I'm not doing it. I rather go and ask permission because it's not mine and I don't want to run into trouble in the long run. So I went to the housing. They spoke to me. The person came with me, helped me to talk. They sent me to scare it to Ian Douglas. I went, the first time I went, I met him. He told us he don't know exactly where, but he told us that he will look into the matter. First, he will call housing, so housing will explain for him better. So anyway, we keep going back and forth, nothing yet. We went back to housing. They tell us they cannot help us. They just, there, but the person that really have this say is either Reginald Austrey or Ian Douglas. So I went to Reginald Austrey. When I went, I met his secretary. She told me he's not in, but he do have landing chance, which she didn't know what I was really talking about. But anyway, she gave me his number. So I called him and he said, you don't know what I'm talking about. So he do aware of no piece of landing chance. Basically, his response was nice. Mm-hmm. Anyways, keep going back to Ian. He told me he would come up to come and check the land. Then once I was in work and housing committee, I had to come up now. So the man would come with me to look at it. That was Mr. Joseph. He came. I came from work. He came with me. I showed him where I wanted. He told me it can take something although they say it was a wife, but it can take a piece of, not big, but something. So he showed me where and where would have taken, but we still had to get the years from Ian original. Anyways, Ian was supposed to give me a letter. I keep going back and forth. Went to the secretary, no Ian. Calling Ian, Ian not answering his phone. If he answer, he tells us he'll check out this and this day. No Ian. So once I went down to Portsmouth, and as I was going, I met him coming up from a bus. I told him I came to him, he told me to come. He sit down, I spoke to him. I told him I really need to get out under the hospital because at that time that gave me notice. So he tell me he will give me a letter. I tell Ian, okay, tell me, come back the Thursday. I say, and I really tell him, yes. When I went, no letter. Secretary don't know nothing about that. And she was supposed to make it. Anyways, I got a little heartbroken. I cried because I check in. I really need that okay, and he promised me. Anyways, that passed. My husband, he went back to Reginald, and he met him. And Reginald Austria, he explained to him, Reginald Austria told him to go back to housing, and he will call housing, and he will make them give him the okay. Nothing. Time passed, I wait. When I do, calling Ian again, Ian not answering his phone, so I text him, and I tell him, this is the girl that was asking for the land, and I really need the help. And basically, they was giving me the okay, so I want to know how soon I will get it.
Yeah.
He texts me back and he tells me house and say it's, they can't take a house, it's not a lot. So I check him, but what happened? So I went back to the housing man. So he tell me Greg, which is higher than him, really did say that is, well, obviously we know it's not a lot, but he said it was a waving and if I take him, it's at my own risk. But it's still me if I want it or not. But he feel to himself they can still take a house because the others below and it's the same waving and nothing that happening. And their house there they live in, one building still on it and nobody not telling them to take out the house. There is a waving, it's not a lot. So what can I do? I still need their okay. So the last time my husband went up there, he said the best thing I can advise him is to talk to Skerrit. So that's what we're going to do. And when we thought that we were going to get the okay, we text Skerrit and we told him the situation. We asked him for help and he texts us back and he said he will help us. But that was probably a month and a half. I think I have the date on that. I cannot see the date now. Let's have to get it on my other phone. But if you look, you will see Skerrit. And it will help you, my brother.
Okay.
So.
That's the situation here right now.
Yes. And it's not like I have money to say I can just go and purchase a piece of land. What you were showing them is like, if we get that rest, we can pile up the money we spend in here, we can save that money and buy a good piece of land. Because we have children, we cannot stay on that forever. But that's the situation. I apply for the houses, but I know it's a long shot. Because people come in and claim, they're saying Skerrit send them, and I know it's not Skerrit, Ian sends them. And I know it's people that is well known, people that they know that will get the horses. So I did not set my mind really on that. So I'll say I'll try, seeing that that's how the things run, I will try to see if I can get that little strip instead. But turns out I didn't get it. And it was disappointing because you see I go back and forth and it was like I have the okay. And at the last minute, they're telling me no. And it's not fair. Because if I cannot, then they should not be having other people on the building living. That's not fair.
Are you more independent?
That's not fair. I still wait in that God's working miracle for us. We still, even if they tell us no, we're still pursuing it, you know. We're still pursuing it. They tell us to check scare it, we're going to do that. Because he's the man that's in charge of everything. So we're going to do that to see if he will give us the okay to do that.
Okay.
Here's all the bedroom.
Yeah. You don't see the bed, can you see?
Yeah.
Right. And next side there. The cook. This bed is because of me. When you finish out.
What is that?
When you finish out, you like put everything there for cook, the whole time thing for cook. In the other kitchen over there.
Okay. I want to see the other kitchen, okay?
So outside, can you
take me there?
Outside, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Let me show you. Outside. Karan. Man, come and see how please be.
Huh?
Man, come and see how please be.
Yeah.
I got the young of this stuff.
So,
he had to have
the kid. Bambala doing that?
Yes, I can't take him longer.
Hey, mother, are you know?
He doesn't look sick.
So, that's the original Cooper house?
Yeah.
And that's where you live, eh?
But you have to send it back. I'm not sure I'm doing
that. Bamba! Morning!
This is the home.
Bamba, let me
go. Yes.
You can come out and you can
do that. You can say it's possible. Yes.
So what is that?
Cooking a fire side.
Oh, so there's only fire side. Yes, so that's like your kitchen then?
Yes, yes. Right. I have a high stove there if I now. Combust order and they take out the cylinder and they go cylinder and the on mangi stove, the cylinder and the stove.
Mm.
So family stove inside there.
So would that do you that? You don't know who?
You don't know who? You don't know who, so I.
And that's right by the river there, we? Yeah. So where are those poo poo now?
Who
are? Yeah. Why is that?
So like when you're still in the toilet.
Mm.
And sometimes you look in the river, go back and there.
Okay. So government ever come there and check out your house? You ever try to see how you can get a house for you to stay in a better house?
Well, you wanna die and come there back in.
Who is that?
The boy, you wanna die.
Who of Daya?
Daya, no, Zika. You wanna Zika, her son.
Uh-huh.
Come there with a book and you're writing there and we tell him I'm going to the toilet, I'm going to the bathroom, I'm going to the proper house.
And what did he say?
He said, Rose, the people help us. We show the people. You can never study, never pass back.
He never pass back?
No. Okay. He did everything possible, he answered me, now. And the transport he was answering me.
Mm.
He never pass back. Now he tell me, Rose, the people will help us. And first of all, the Rose will come out to do that for us.
But you need a better house?
Yeah, yeah. As you can see.
Mm-hmm.
What's that? Yeah. I'm studying that.
So what your boyfriend have to say about that now, yes? About the housing thing? Or do you ever try to get houses in chance?
Well, Friday we say we go in there, every day I tell him we're supposed to go there. We have to give
an attempt?
Yes.
Okay.
They have to get a house in chance. They say, put a card to, like a full card down there, put a card for us.
Mm-hmm.
I put in the office, so you chase us and nothing, you tell him that we go to Ian.
How long ago that was?
Long time me.
Uh-huh.
Yes, don't get me.
And they never commanded
nothing
for you?
Because Carnival Levy, the woman gone, they give you one the cat to give us to the office.
Mm-hmm.
For her to go and make put in the office for us to get out.
Up till now, nothing?
I don't know.
How long you staying inside the room?
Long time, eh? Long, long time.
How much you so?
I
know. How long so?
Long time.
Are you going to put inside the boy
house? And you come on there. Come on there. There's a young up, sometimes you wash the young up there.
Mm.
They look nice, huh? And sometimes you do that one, and you get them, you just back quiet to put them clothes.
Before?
You just back quiet to open some clothes.
Mm.
anywhere you're sleeping in there. When they dry, taking them out.
Okay.
I can see that. This one, you know, I don't drive on. I drive on, but I'm going to come back with you. You can go to chance. But I know who. I'm going to say, he say, it's the boy that I said, yeah, endless houses in chance. So then we can get one. So I don't know how to purify it.
You don't know how to go about getting a house, right?
And they also. I'm working the way. Well, if you help me make money, I don't work in the way. Up now, we can't get the money, yeah? Up now, we can't get the money. My care give me this one to eat. I drink some water, I take my medication, and medication, eh?
What's your medication for?
So we can have blackout.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay.
I must take it, I must take my treatment. Whenever I take it, they will take me blackout, take me, and take me. Rose Hospital, I was, you know, all the time, you know, I was seeing me there, Rose Hospital.
But you just have food every day, boy?
Not every day, I have food, man. I lack of food. Yeah, I tell you, Mike, I gave you a big this morning. I lack of food. I don't get married for money yet.
Mm.
And I go, no food, no money. Money, not commit, no money. Yeah. So, every time I go, I don't want to go. Mm. And the official boss now, he go by this post this morning. I ask this post, they have no money to help me. Mm. He tell me they can't help me, they have money. They have money. I tell them, I don't want to provide. I am not going to provide for you, because you say I'm not going to provide for you. You will provide for you. If I drink tea, I sure to get supper, but not lunch.
So how are you sleeping on that bed there?
Yeah?
Mm.
Wait. You sleeping good. That bed, that two mattresses that time. That big one there is my own.
Hmm?
That big one there. And
okay.
Wow, cockroach, she's in a squash, all of them meet.
Back from the very scratch with a sample to OECS News Link next hour.
This is News Link.
The OECS News Link is brought to you by Dominica's Jazz and Creole
and Monroe College.
The government of the Commonwealth of Dominica discovered
to develop a cadre of maritime experts on island.
He's noted.
Since Rosie was alive, I check in Rosie, Rosie, he tell me right how much children I have in my house, how much of house and thing. And since that time, I asked him, he tell me write him a letter, he write me back and tell me I'll get a house. And so he died. I don't get nothing.
And you have been making attempts for your house all that time?
Mm-hmm. Yes. And since that time I behind them for years, I behind them. Reginald come there. Huh? I tell him much where I live in, right in the same house. Try to take me out there. He tell me you send Greg and check me. I don't see Greg up to now. Huh? Greg never come here. I don't know. Since the day of Rosie.
You order
it. And when my two girls died there, and my grandson, my son, I have three of them, you know. But my big son in Antigua.
Okay.
I work in food, that's not money. That's not money. I know that the little money I have to pay out $400. Someone give me a little change. I cannot do nothing for a thing. I have to pay water. I have to pay light. sat.
That's those children's school fees and their...
Those children's school fees, especially she. Every time she went to school, I must give her $5 for her to thing. Mm. Yes, I have to give her something. A little change.
It's difficult.
Yeah. Sometimes I don't even have to give her. I have to tell her to take things from my KK.
It's hard, it's hard.
Very hard for me. Especially she going to school, money. I have to make sure I buy the thing for her to do her project. It's hard on me.
Who is
my No help. Not getting help.
So basically, for the assistance you need is materials. Okay.
Yes, if I get the materials, so then I got have a piece of land. If my mother gives me a piece of land in charge, then I can build on it. Mm. So.
You ever come to Ian Douglas?
I go to him all the time. He doesn't ever come here, he never come there. Neither Reginald. Reginald come right there and talk to the lady there, show him where I live in. Up to now, nothing. All they're telling me, they will check me.
Or nothing yet. Margo is
I still there. Yeah, I still there. And I see the piece of house want to fall down on me. Myself say anytime that will fall down, but it's not strong up there. The owner tell me some boys that do that fast for her boyfriend. All those things falling down, all in the bathroom. I don't know. There's nothing I can do for that. I pay in every month $400.
For nothing.
They just have toilets. Just watch them for $400.
You're praying, cuz?
I must do that way. They are saying, I am not. But every day, I must be in two areas. But if I'm not, chaos.
So if you're not in your prayers, it's chaos.
Yes.
And here is the man himself.
Yeah, man.
Yes, cuz.
How are you doing, Papa?
I'm doing super fantastic, my brother. Every day above ground healthy is a great day.
I know. Thank God for everything.
Don't know.
Yeah, man. Well, Nana, in time of emergency, like now, would have that.
True.
Because now in the line of that, eh? That's the man himself. The president of Labas. Yeah. You need to get this project to the very low. That's my thing, Mr. I mean. In his turn.
There are a couple holes up in there, eh?
Better. You know, I'm not asking for what who's copy your honor. Oh God. Yeah. My name is Cedric Thomas. I'm the community now of Zikat Portsmouth. And I am doing another kind of shoemaking, you know, for my life, but I've been attacked by light stroke in a recently. So I cannot, you know, go with the process of now the sewing process, as you know, too fast right now, or after this is going down. And more, you know. Living my life because I am not doing well at all. I have been trying to get process as this is done since from 15 years now, yeah, and more. And nobody haven't hearing me. Nobody haven't going into my process of situation. Did I use the right symptoms? Thank you very much. No, I want to get things right. Okay. No, recently, they passed on the overhaul my home where I'm living at. Yeah, I was desperately sick. Really sick.
What was your sickness? What problem you had? What's your illness?
It was the same illness than of the stroke.
Okay.
I know. I could not move my legs. I could not do nothing much now out of myself. Up to now, I still cannot go up the wheelchair and I cannot put on my high pants now, yeah, on me still.
Okay.
Okay. See the condition of my hands.
Okay.
Your man Ben? I put it in front of the camera.
Sure.
Okay. You, yeah, all you see it?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, I have been suffering from this past time to now, okay? Sorry for my slow speech, okay, because I'm stammering.
It's okay, go ahead.
But I need, and I really in need of a piece of land and a house off of me on my own.
Have anybody came here from housing or parliamentary representative to see your living condition?
The one that they said that in charge of Portsmouth is a beautiful, funny joke. Yeah, it's just as the water that I go down, yeah, in a river. Yes, it's peace. Yes, it's peace. He'll answer you yes right now. And I mean to turn your back on. I mean to turn his back now, yeah, on you. You finish. I don't know if all will be like to hear that. I don't know if if you all like to hear what I'm going to say, but
speak your mind, man.
I don't know if it's not, yeah, I don't have China. That is why he is not helping me out, because now, yeah, I heard that mostly all process that is going on, yeah, up in Chance, which is nine with housing, is mostly women that is getting everything. Okay, so what are you trying to own and motivate, you know, into your head?
Okay. Did the power ever came here to see your building?
He came here once. He came here once. He came once. He told me
he would have come back up to now.
And how long ago that was?
That was 10 years ago.
10 years ago?
Yes.
Okay, wow.
10 years ago.
So have anybody ever came here to say that, you know, Sergeant Killers, I want to help you get a house? Anybody else? Huh. Apart from government?
I would get so much good offers already. Yeah, nothing I've learned into the book yet.
Not yet, okay.
To not feel the aid of. Well, I don't know which one to maybe believe, which one to not believe. I not give up. I'm not living my life. Mm. I know, well, anytime now, as I've been over now and beyond, I'll not come in so ways to hide, baby. Because, hey, my means then of situation is not good at all, okay? I am in need, bad. I'm just in need.
Have you ever tried to commit suicide before?
Yes.
What did you do?
I drank poison twice. And I hung myself once.
Why did you attempt to do that?
Because I was really stressed out. I did not have possibility out of myself. And I did not have freedom. It's okay. Yeah. Boy. If I have to share my mind, I mind, eh?
Go ahead, you can do so. Trust. Go ahead, show your mind.
You will swear and say it's a library.
So how long have you been in that situation there with your legs and everything like that? Because right now you're not walking. I see you don't even have any pants on because you need somebody to help you put on your pants, right?
Yes, it's fine.
Yeah, go ahead.
Well, I took to the liquid better. Before.
Mm-hmm. At what age, so?
About 40. Yes. 40 years, so.
Mm.
I was still up, you know, helping out myself, you know, checking, man. I little, you know, move still, but when I reach now 41, I happen to only just, you know, start to now get ill, and that was the rest of the process.
But before, I knew you for some time now, and you were not able to walk for some time, right?
Yeah, long now.
What age?
It's the age now of 6 years. I used to walk, like you and others.
Mm-hmm.
Fine.
Okay. So from since 6, you basically cannot walk?
No, disabled, flat down.
Okay. And then you were starting to walk again. At what age you had started walking again?
I used to always walk, but I was not too say strong. I used to always be falling down.
Okay, I understand.
You know, and checking my eyes.
Can go ahead, that is your bed.
Yes. That's my bed. That's where I am sleeping. But I have a flask and a bag and a plastic and a pant I'm going to wash on the outside.
Mm.
But I do not know who I'll get to put me now on the wheelchair. No. My main switch go bad. Fire catching to it. And when I'm off living there, right now is not so good at all. So night time, I just been a risk to now sleep there.
Also? Yeah.
Oh, you mean also?
No, you say you're at risk at night.
Okay, because scientists does all not creep up now, on me and them one night they risk.
I see you have a kind of the kind of size centipede outside there you kill, I suspect. That like what, 1, 2, or maybe close to 8 inches length.
8 inches in length, bro.
Yeah.
And in the next one, that ape of my eyebrow, 8 or 9 inches long.
Okay, wow.
And let me tell you, it was much more darker
than that one outside.
Yes. Or almost when anytime that gosh, Amy. No. If I did not try to help out myself.
So you have a centipede problem inside.
Very much. That night, you know, I happened to talk at three of them, and let me.
Wow.
Oh, you know, like that told me by next time. This.
Okay.
Is the picture. This.
Okay.
I mean, go. Those mosquitoes on them is not nice so much.
No problem for you.
Let me go up now. Reese sent there last night. Oh man, in this summer.
Okay. Then you pass on your skin?
Yes.
Okay.
And last night I tried did now, yeah, and let me to tell you that I don't know why I have no more skin for some.
So it walking goes.
You know, it have no smell, no kind of smell.
No smell whatsoever, eh?
No smell, no. No kind of smell.
But it's less, but it walking goes.
Hey, no, it didn't really work in.
Okay.
So, if my laughing noya are too chronic, so sorry about that. Yeah? Because that is how now I'm releasing my Ella.
Yeah.
I'm even harsh.
So, you're releasing your. So, what do you do for entertainment?
I have a radio, dear. I just open it each time, but as I don't have light there right now, it is a main hurt to my heart.
Yeah, because you're the only company gone.
Yeah, but
does people normally come and visit you here?
When they feel like.
Okay.
But I just get visit. No kind of close complaint. Even though I am not getting. But I just see them. But I really need them. And right now, for so long, I give up.
You reach a point as a 42-year-old man that you think that you give up on life, eh?
I give up. But if a process can happen to make me feel happier in my means and ways now, yeah, of unpleasantness, I will feel convivial. It can even help me now to 2 days long hunger.
Okay, I understand what you're saying.
Because, you know,
difficult, huh?
Very much. Or it is not no more difficult than someone else, but yeah, as fast somebody can see, I used to live in a whole lot than that nobody before.
Okay,
it nine it that for long now, yeah, and caught me in my forehead there.
Okay, so the house actually fell on you,
yeah, that body, yes, we, but this one did it enough. Thank you, Jesus, at least, you know? And so, even though it is not to say, you know, so presentable, but if somebody come to me, they can sit down, you know, and if a wind blow, I'd have to go and hold also and jam postman boy before.
Right. So you had it had for a very long time, huh?
Yes.
Very long time,
yes.
Huh?
Very much. I actually see when I hang my cell bus recently, but now yeah, I actually see. I know in a man go, and it now come back to me now, yeah, and the robots, and I feel long.
You are 42 years old.
Yes.
You live in a terrible housing situation.
Yes,
what is it that you really want? You call it, you even call here Labas.
Yes, fine.
And what is it that you really want, man?
I need of a piece of land and a house. And according to the to the retage of the house.
Mm-hmm.
Retage
mm-hmm.
of the house. I would like an addition of now 10 feet now, yeah, on it. Or I can
have your little workshop and
yes,
thing, right? Because you are a shoemaker by profession. That's how you make your money.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah.
Okay.
So if the Prime Minister is watching that video right now, what would you want to say to him? And you can watch the camera in the middle of it.
Yes.
Like you are speaking to our Prime Minister of Dominica, which is Mr. Roosevelt's cabinet. What would you say to him?
I would have said to him, Mr. Prime Minister, I saw you now already. Yeah, I saw you twice. And I know you very well. You are from the village now, yeah, of Vickers. Once I saw you sat down below the fifth center church in the bus stop. It was a Christmas day. Yeah, and once I saw it in the Lifeline Christian Fellowship Church. So twice I saw you already, okay, but you don't know me. Okay, because nobody happened to say, you know, introduce you to me. So I'm just saying to you right now what you are saying on the video right now there, it is not a need. It is not a want, it is not a need. Okay, so could you please, I am begging you, please, it's not asking, I am begging you. Could you please speed up the scenario and help a needy? And anybody that is seeing this video right now, it is a need. So help a needy, please, because every day I see the most, I open my eyes now, yeah, and I see the brightness of creation. What that is into my mind is not so inside, because I am checking, nobody is not here for me, nobody is not for me, and I am left apart. Okay, I am living just as a floating boat, yeah, on the channel that is empty. No sail, no engine, nobody to no control it. That is my life right now. And my mother is now going down straight and depend, yeah, on her to help me that much again. So what is the enemy you head against Jinan? So he you know, he had supposed to now came yet to Labast years back, but I do not know if it's my voice here over the radio, and he happened to know he came in today, and is not he that said himself here. is the Most High, which is God. So, help and needy. Yeah, all those that seen that. Portsmouth, no rent isn't Asian at all. When I mean none, I mean blank. And I am disabled, and I'm not in a wheelchair, and I'm not, you know, we as disabled, we have no voice in Portsmouth at all, okay? That I go to say, no, yeah, and I'm straight right now. We as disabled, no, yeah, then. Sorry for saying twice, we have no voice, because when we talk, it's as though now our means and ways buried. So long I've been asking for a motor light, Jeff, or me to have a free up now around the tongue, or me to go and see people, you know, I did not even know it's too bad, you know. Nobody are not hearing me. Okay, all what I'm asking for is not, no, is not, is a wheelchair there again, and I cannot manage a wheelchair myself. I need not offer power rise thing, you know, so I can, you know, attach current to it, and I move. Right. You know, nobody not hear me at all. The house now, the piece now, of land serve. Oh, my soul, let me. God forbid. Mm-hmm. But I would have passed a nice baby egg word, but you know, a God righteous is there. Yeah, I heard your name, over the radio, good. All the righteous therapy.
None.
All. Yeah, man. Even though I'm ugly, but I have no. I cannot to say speak the English properly, but I can explain, you know. Yes, no, I will tell you, okay?
Just do your thing, man. I have a piece by me too. But it be a bigger piece.
I don't like here. I want a bigger piece. Yeah, come on. Only crazy.
Okay. So basically your bed is cardboard.
Yeah, man. Cardboard on your hand. Highboard.
So you apply board on that, and then on top of it is cardboard, and like a sheet, and you like a pillow, and that is your bed right there, yes?
Yeah. Yes, course. Inside. Everything course. Oh. All.
Don't
laugh, man.
How you
doing? Open your mouth. It's all.
Don't laugh,
your brother. No, it's all. No, please. Need of a little decent man there right now. Like, organize this room. Just like that. Should be different. To me.
Hmm?
Who they are, this one?
Why is that?
I said.
Mm-hmm.
I heard he was talking about on the radio the other day.
Oh.
Asking about what you have in mind, you're not going to do, and so. Everything in the world. Fix. Before I
with my mom.
Watch now your all and two, you know.
All.
God is our fair.
So you see, we need to try it now?
Yeah,
that's good.
Yeah.
No, after all, your two hands.
Hold my hands, yeah, on my two hands. Hey, be careful with this, Papa. Be careful with this.
I make, but I don't see what I want to do.
Hold it, man. Hold it.
One, twice, together. And your wood outside.
Oh yes. All.
You go. You can put your socio in a little bit.
I'll try.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. I had one.
Thank
you,
Jesus.
Okay.
Yes, all.
So you set up?
Yeah.
Set your back.
Yeah.
The storm keeps on twisting. You keep on building the lie that you make up for all that you lack. It don't make no difference. Escape for one last time. It's easier. In this sweet madness, of all this glorious sadness that brings me to my knees. In the arms of the angels, fly away from here, from this dark. Of your soul.